Rachel Wilkinson and Jamie Davies are an alternative indie duo currently named Ivy and Gold. They are originally from Hertfordshire, England, but are now currently based in London. They first met at a barbecue and later realised that they had a true skill in music and that individual sound needed to be shared amongst one another, and they openly collaborated with each other, creating new material. Jamie applies his musical talent through the use of instruments, drums and keyboard, whereas Wilkinson presents her gift of music through her voice alone, as she is vocally capable. The duo's name is Ivy and Gold, which is originally from the Bombay Bicycle Club, as they named a song Ivy and Gold. The duo are great fans of these artists and got the best response from their own fans when they suggested it. Rachel states how her influences come from Stevie Nicks, Fleetwood Mac, Tori Amos, Kate Bush and artists who are currently in today's industry, such as Banks, Lana Del Rey and Florence and the Machine. Davies, however, is known to be influenced by mainly producers rather than singers. Davies explored electronic sounds by producers such as Diplo and Max Martin before applying his something to classic pop songwriting. Ivy and Gold produced their first project called Awake, with a track list consisting of four songs: Ghost, Home, Look at Me and Last of the Town. The release date was September 4th, 2014. This is the song, we're just going to play a little bit of it.
Yeah, it's brilliant.
Mysterious. The way that we choose to represent these themes is through the mise-en-scène, editing and camera work. The respondents from our focus group stated that our song creates a melancholy atmosphere and holds connotations of death. There are numerous crescendos and diminuendos in our song, meaning that tension rises and falls throughout. It's just a new board that we made. We have some music video influences there. The first one that we chose was Imagine Dragons' Radioactive. The beginning of the music promo has influenced our final production because it consists of a female protagonist walking through the woods. As Imagine Dragons can be identified as an indie pop band, it is clear that the forest is a conventional location of an indie pop music promo, and then the other one is Thriller by Michael Jackson. We decided to make an intertextual reference with this iconic music video to create a sense of familiarity and nostalgia for the audience. As the video was released in 1982, we intend to attract an older audience as well as a younger audience, such as the ones who watched and liked this video at the time of release.
Michael Shaw, Recycle Styles. We are recycling typical indie pop conventions when it comes to mise-en-scène. The setting we are incorporating in our music video is a location frequently denoted in other videos of the indie pop genres. Cliched imagery. Within our video, we will be incorporating shots of a drum being hit. This acts as a cliched imagery because it's a feature that is common within music videos of a range of different genres. Ronan Barthes, building a narrative. Enigma code. This refers to any element that is not explained and therefore exists as an enigma. We will include an enigma code in our music video because the audience will be unaware as to why our protagonist is having unusual dreams. An enigma code also raises questions, and we intend to also do this in our final production. Todorov's narrative theory. Equilibrium. Our protagonist is noted in bed sleeping, creating a calm and peaceful atmosphere. Disruption. She wakes up in the woods surrounded by darkness. As the video progresses, she encounters obstacles such as a wolf. Restoration. She comes to face with this creature, realizes she's dreaming and wakes up. And then Levi Strauss, binary opposition. There's a clear distinction between fantasy and reality in our music video. The narrative of our video consists of protagonist finding it difficult to distinguish between the two. The narrative comes to an end when she finally realizes what she's experienced is not reality, but fantasy. This represents that there is a clear contrast between fantasy and reality in our music video.
Steve Archer. Steve Archer argues that there needs to be a strong, coherent relationship between narrative and performance. Despite the fact that our music video is predominantly narrative, we will include slight aspects of performance throughout, including like the drumming and lip syncing. Through these elements of performance, we intend to create a coherent relationship between narrative and performance. Our idea for our music video is that our narrative will follow our protagonist distinguishing between fantasy and reality. However, the audience will not be aware of this until the end of the music promo. The video starts with an extreme close-up of the protagonist's eyes zooming out into a wide shot of her in a forest. This creates a sense of setting, allowing the audience to understand the whereabouts of the protagonist. As the video progresses, the main character has to overcome trials and tribulations while making the audience aware that it isn't reality. Finally, as these obstacles are overcome, the protagonist wakes and suddenly realizes that everything that took place was a dream. For our camera work, we're going to use long shots and crane shots. These will create a sense of setting and make the protagonist look isolated and alone. High angles will connote the main characters weak and powerless. Pans, tilts, tracks will create a sense of chaos and uncertainty. Zooms focus on hinting towards the next aspect of the narrative, and close-ups will emphasise the feelings of the protagonist, mainly fear and confusion, as she aims to distinguish between fantasy and reality.
Within the costume of our mise-en-scene, at the beginning of the promo, she'll be wearing all black, and this shows like a sense of darkness and mystery within the video. But as she wakes up and realises it's a dream, she'll be wearing white, because it shows a sense of purity and innocence, and this also links to Levi Strauss's binary oppositions. And the lighting within our music video will appear low-key throughout the fantasy location, creating a sense of mystery. However, in the reality location, it'll become more high-key, emphasising the binary opposition between the two. The actor will be Grace Pengelly, so in the majority of the video she'll be featuring in the sole Kirsten. The main character will be wearing a dark, intense makeup throughout the segment of the forest. However, she won't be wearing any when she wakes up. And then the props will be a dog and a wolf mask, as well as smoke bombs and the drum to create the mystery. And then the setting, there will be two settings included in our music video. The first will be the forest, and then the second will be the bedroom. Within the editing, we're going to include an eyeline match between the dog and the protagonist at the end of the extract. And then we'll include jump cuts to create a sense of chaos. We'll also include fast motion to build tension and a time lapse to represent the passing of time. And within our ancillaries, for our digipack, we're going to include the protagonist on the cover, and there'll be synergetic links created through a consistent colour scheme, which is grey, purple and blue. There'll also be a barcode, the name of the band, and information about their record label. And within the music poster, the protagonist will be in the central third of the Rule of Thirds, and this will include the same colour scheme, and there'll be tour dates as well on the poster.